Welcome to my party, we're just getting started. A life is a dream or a nightmare scarring. Hand me a drink cause I think I'm going all in. Get me a shrink who can catch me when I'm falling. Cover up my scars, flip the handlebars. Crashing in my car, wake up in a bar. I'll be a superstar, just on my avatar. This world is so bizarre, empty out the reservoir. Yeah, I'm taking 6 shots, yeah, straight to the face.
Here we have John Morrison, a superstar known by many names, many nicknames. Perhaps the most applicable for his in-ring action, though, is the Prince of Parkour.
Now, that parkour offensive style derived from military obstacle course training, what you're going to see is Morrison use every bit of his environment as offensive weaponry. Morrison will use every inch of his surroundings to his advantage here.
And combined with the years he spent away from WWE honing his craft, learning new styles from all over the world, you never quite know what you're going to see from Morrison.
And then we should talk about the many faces of Jeff Hardy.
He could be looking for a submission here. Gets to the ropes, and that's going to cause the ref to break the hold. He goes for the cover. And a kick out.
He ain't getting paid by the hour.
Nice amateur takedown. All the way over.
The springboard attack fails to land. Reversal on Morrison. Face first.
Really just laying it in.
Corey, John Morrison is obviously quite the talented athlete, but if you could pinpoint one thing that he needs to focus on here, what would you say it is?
Without a doubt, Morrison needs to stick with what...
Up high! Crossbody!
He thinks he has it! No, he pops the shoulder before three!
That was a long two count there.
Look at this, Byron, putting the pressure on now. Body is not meant to bend that way.
For the love of...
spinning through.
Struck with precision.
We've seen this fire many, many years out of Jeff Hardy.
Look out.
And there's the cover.
What's it gonna take to keep this guy down?
My, oh my, what elevation!
trapped. And now a series of stomps and kicks.
That unorthodox offensive stop.
And this is gotta be it.
One, two.
Barely kicks out.
Getting that shoulder up now is huge.
He's going for it all.
And just finish this.
Two. John Morrison captures the win.
Here is your winner, John Morrison.
Cementing their name after that match.
Definitely earning those accolades with that win.
That was just a pitiful performance by Jeff Hardy here tonight.
You can't fight like that and expect to be a winner.
Here comes the queen, the franchise, and the self-proclaimed opportunity.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making her way to the ring from the Queen City, Charlotte Flair!
You know, the WWE Universe, at least many in it, believe that she's been handed title opportunities in main events.
Well, many of those same doubters live in their parents' basements, Cole. I wouldn't necessarily value their opinion. This is Charlotte Flair. This is the queen. This is...
We talk a lot about Charlotte's gracefulness in the ring, so I suppose it really is no surprise that she insists on being called the queen of WWE.
Yeah, but not just the queen of WWE, Cole, the queen of all eras. A title she earned, a title she's maintained with every distinguished move she makes in the ring, every devastating statement she makes against the peasants. She lowers herself to face for the enjoyment of the unwashed masses.
Charlotte's point of view certainly has legs, but I saw...
Oof, she is not abused in the slightest.
Charlotte is a competitor whose reputation precedes her. Corey, how do you stop a superstar as a cop?
Oh, boy, here it comes. Will she get it fully locked in?
Oh, man, there's nowhere for her. A single leg camel clutch and a great counter. Ouch. And a drop kick.
Picture perfect.
Re-entering the ring now. Flair retaliating. And countouts are legal, so hopefully this will be a short trip outside. She heads into the ring.
She's on unsteady legs in the corner. Needs to recover.
submission won't be one to back down either.
The Queen came into this match with the express purpose of putting a beating on a peasant, and that was a step closer to it.
Carefully placed stomp to the arm.
Just breaking down the opponent.
Counter! And now there's an opening. And oh my God, what a far!
Right to the jaw.
And she had Zaya's number there.
In control here with a swinging neck into the cover.
She is still fighting, still keeping this going.
Saw it with the boot.
And the Queen of All Air is making a definitive statement with that move. In fact, let's call it a royal proclamation.
Charlotte Flair ruling with an iron fist.
The Queen stepping through. Here's the figure four.
Yeah, now she's got a bridge into the figure eight. If she can do it, she's going to put this one away.
In. This one's over. This one is over.
Charlotte Flair can taste the victory.
patience working out perfectly.
She avoids the contact. What a punch. Oh, look at this.
Gutbuster.
She's taking a beating here.
Well, all things considered, Cole, it's not a bad condition to be in at this point in the match.
Banzai!
It could be over here!
This is it!
A tremendous win in this match.
Maybe Sasha Banks needs to hit the showers, rest up tonight, and start reading the want ads in the morning, because this job is...
You know, after arriving here in WWE, Umaga quickly earned himself a vicious reputation. Everyone came to learn that he pulls no punches in the ring, and in fact even enjoys inflicting pain and suffering on his opponents.
Umaga loves nothing more than to conquer his competition by the most grisly means possible. He shows no remorse inside the ring and fights like a man who has gone to war.
And that's exactly what makes Umaga a frightening opponent. I'm sure we'll see his most bloodthirsty tactics in this one.
And coming into tonight, Randy Orton continues to carry his one objective. The objective to stand above everyone.
A goal the Viper has accomplished many times over.
No!
Oh, that'll break his arm. Vicious. A lot of game tape out there on Randy Orton. Certainly would be best to build a strap on the top.
Elbow drop. Good lord.
Shoulders down for the count.
Kicks out in time.
A strong kick out to stay in the fight.
Oh!
Umaga is in a distressing spot.
This devastating offense from Orton is so hard to prepare for.
Taking his time. That could just be a warning shot of things to come from the Viper.
Stand in Randy Orton's way, and this is something you'll have coming.
Umaga with a retaliation.
Umaga showing he can't be trifled with for too long.
Flatline.
Oh, Randy Orton has been busted open.
Headbutt.
This could be it.
Cover for the win.
One, two.
He kicks out at two.
How?
Forearm club.
Oh, what a clubbing blow.
Whoa.
Stiff headbutt. He saw it coming, taking advantage.
And the DDT.
He could pin his opponent right here.
It's over.
One, two, three.
And it's a victory.
They count to me. They understand. They talk to me.
What a great win to the superstar. Incredible victory.
Hard-fought matchup, and looks
looks like. Yeah, I like that. A little sign of respect.
Maybe not.
A sore loser.
There's only one Mr. WrestleMania. He's a showstopper.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring, weighing in at 227 pounds.
The Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels.
Ladies and gentlemen, there is a reason that this man's nickname is Mr. WrestleMania, one of the greatest performers in the history of WWE. After missing nearly...
I can't imagine what it's like facing off against Undertaker, a man who approaches his matches with grim determination, a man who has defeated countless all-time greats, a man who enters the ring tonight intent on seeing his opponent rest in peace.
And then put yourself in Shawn Michaels' shoes tonight. This is arguably the greatest of all time. He's had enough of the blatant disrespect come his way.
Heartbreak Kid hasn't been the most noble of character himself, but the bell's already rung. His focus has to be placed on winning matches, not what people say in the locker room or on the internet.
Undertaker, HBK, the rivalry between these men transcends sports entertainment. While their careers are paralleled in many ways, they're very different. Different as competitors and as people, leading completely different ways of life. But one thing they have in common is they're both winners.
Yeah, but only one of these men can leave here tonight victorious.
Undertaker is a master at playing mind games, but if anyone has played mind games with a dead man, it's Shawn Michaels. His brash arrogance infuriates the Phenom.
Take off!
That was terrible, Byron. Hoping to end it early.
One, two,
and he gets two at a time.
I am surprised the count went that far. Oh, man, that was nasty.
They weren't that good looking anyway. Rear chin lock, and now just rapid fire punches.
The pace is quick and courtesy of Shawn Michaels.
You can bet the dead man won't rest here. He went right into that turnbuckle.
Oh, drop.
Undertaker looking mortal here.
First one missed, second one didn't.
Effective. Whipped into the corner. Man, he hit hard.
Oh, wait a minute.
I knew this was coming. It was just a matter of time. Hey, there's still a match going on.
Well, these two are getting heated up right now.
Well, the other guy should be thrown out of here. No reason to even be at ringside. And, oh, what a right hand taking advantage. You knew this was going to happen.
The WWE Universe is pouring more fuel on his fire right now.
Elbow drop.
Piercing.
Two.
Agonizing.
He's
staring his opponent down, getting into that zone.
The wherewithal to counter HBK. He heads outside. Countouts legal in this match. Ooh. Reversal by the Undertaker. Oh, what a punch.
Everyone get out of the way. These two are abandoning all restraints.
Three. Oh, a big uppercut.
Four. Uh-oh.
Look at this. He just tossed the leg.
He's absorbing some tough hits now.
And hanging tough, but beginning to show some wear and tear. Might want to think about picking up the pace a bit.
He's in, under the ropes. Great reversal.
Caught with a punch.
Give in first.
Oh, sweet chin music.
All the life drained from the dead man.
Oh, shoulder up before three.
The trademark resolve of the Undertaker on display. He will not stay down.
And Michaels is so used to ending matches like this.
Up high.
That was terrible, Byron.
Undertaker moves just in time.
Vicious right forearm. Ooh, what a damaging blow. Leg drop.
That's gotta be it.
There's two. Digging deep for a kick out.
And you gotta think, he's just one final blow away from not kicking out next time.
Trying to find his bearings, but it looks like his end is near. Michael saves himself.
Axe handle from the middle rope.
Yeah. Here we go.
Inverted DDT.
Lights out. This has got to be demoralizing for Michaels.
Taker is digging another hole. Vice-like grip on the trapezius muscle. This is terribly painful. Exit, but if it works, it works.
Taking this to the floor.
Ooh, well measured.
And a kick. Oh, man. Leg breaker.
Two.
Oh, great. Rearranging our ringside furniture here. Clear the announce desk.
What a mess.
Look at him totally vibing with the WWE Universe right now.
Uh-oh, from way up high.
Taker's about to end another fight.
Two.
Near fall.
You can never count the Heartbreak Kid out, guys. Michaels refuses to concede this fight.
The Undertaker is now realizing that his opponent refuses to rest in peace.
Mere men would not have survived what Michaels and Taker have put each other through tonight.
These aren't men. These are legends.
Two.
Heads outside, but this one has to end in the ring.
Talk about dismantling your opponent.
Systematic attack on that shoulder.
Under the ropes now.
Five. Six.
Shawn Michaels on the corner. Sweet chin music.
And the Phenom has been taking on some hellacious offense.
It's not every day you see the Undertaker forced into a life or death situation like this one.
Amazing kick out from the Undertaker. His resilience tonight is unreal.
And guys, Michaels is stunned. HBK thought it.
High risk. HBK from the top. No one does it better.
Michaels digging into the heart of Taker with that.